that or something. Thank God. What's that? Praise the Lord. Nice to him, I guess. But we was sitting there telling him, was he even listening to us?
Damn.
We were hitting all the scriptures, like talking to him. Like, we're like telling him this, you know? What was that scripture? Let me read this again.
You think he had, when you remember what he was reading?
Yeah. He's like, I got a precept. And he sounded like one of the Christians reading, didn't he?
Yep.
It didn't sound, you know what, it don't sound right when they read it.
Don't read like a man. Don't read like a fucking man, you know? I got nothing.
I'm going to read this one more time because I don't think the camera got it. I want the scripture to get out. Luke 14 and 26. If any man come to me and hate not his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple. And whosoever doth not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. So if you come, oh, I'm a child of God, I'm blessed, the Lord love me, God love me. If you're not doing his work, he don't love you. He can't stand you.
That's why a lot of people fall out with stuff. That's why family's constantly here, man. You know, a lot of people, you want to visit with something. They fall victim to it. They get weak, man, just fall out. Just fall out.
And that's why the scripture said that. You don't hate.
I'm sorry, man. I love you, man. I didn't mean to be out there with them niggas. Blasphemy in the world.
That was just a phase I was going through.
Right.
You hear a lot of dudes say that when they when they say, oh, I'm out of the truth. Or, yeah. It's like, I was just a phase I was going through.
That would be some funny videos.
That is what a fun video.
It's
bro.
A funny ass video. Dude was in his bed making a video.
He was amazing. I didn't even ever study or nothing anyway.
That's amazing, man.
I got on videos though.
Right. And some people think, some brothers fell out, they did little work and they think that's enough. They think that's enough, man. So, and they actually go around showing people the videos. Like, you know?
I know it's fire.
Right.
I be praying, I don't stop doing this. You talking about the chariot. If you seen the chariot, why would you stop doing this? That don't even make sense right
now. They're real. The angels is watching us, man.
Right. You know what I'm saying?
Right. They're angels, man. Just because they ain't coming closer, showing you all, it's an angel in there.
Oh.
They gotta come close. They gotta abduct your ass close. We ain't in the past, man. We got the same prophets in the past. Well, there was a prophet that got abducted. Actually, there was several. Well, you can use the word abducted. But,
he got beamed up.
Right.
Enoch got beamed up. You know? Elijah got beamed up.
Right. Remember the one that was grabbed by the crown and taken to Daniel in the pit?
Oh, yeah.
You know? Habakkuk?
Oh, yeah.
Right, you know? That's being abducted.
Yeah, you're right. I forgot about that one.
And there's another one, too. Similar to that one that Trevor.
Like that Daniel got beamed up himself, didn't he, or something? I can't remember. But we done seen too many signs and stuff out here while he was teaching too, like this crazy bugged out shit we see. So-called coincidences that be happening left and right. I know it's real when I'm around somebody in court. And I'm fucking mad as hell. Like, what's up with this goddamn bullshit around me, bro? You smell pork, you just automatically lose your shit, you know? That reminds you that, yeah, you're in the truth. Just shit like that. When that Christmas time come around, you start hating that shit, you know? Shit, just when you see 2/3, that is enough to set you up.
Oh.
You see a hoe or a trainee walk down the street, a proud-ass trainee walking down the street.
Proud as shit,
yeah. That shit will set you off, man. I'm going blind right here.
What?
This line is a lot of them. I can feel the light.
The light.
Remember the Blues Brothers?
Yeah.
That's what they think. That's what they think that the Lord's gonna say. You gonna go to church? We start doing flips and shit. Oh, the Lord is with us.
Oh, the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, watch.
I'm recording my phone. Somebody giving me the testimony, or their testimony of the Holy Spirit. Get them in church, man. There's some shit that should need to be on Def Comedy Channel.
Right. They come up and hit you with the Bible. Like, I was watching this one pastor. He come up and he was just like, he's going.
This bitch just said this the other day. Like, the Holy Spirit, she's speaking tongues, and everybody in the church started doing the same thing.
They can understand each other, right? That's crazy.
I can't help but here's the abduction. This is Bella and Dragon. Habakkuk said, Lord, I never saw that. I know where the king is. Then the angel of the Lord took him by the crown and buried him by his hair and his head. And through the vehemency of the Spirit, set him in Babylon over the dead.
Yeah, set him in Babylon. For the vehemency of the Spirit. That's that word right there.
That's like anger and force and power. First of all, angels look scary as fuck as it is.
The chariot's come like a whirlwind.
Ooh.
I seen that chariot of fire the other night, boy. That's the first one I seen a fire. Usually when I seen it, it look like a star, you know? I see that. First time I seen it, like a fiery.
That shit go be out there. That's what the color hammer.
Yeah, the hammer, yeah. It was giant. It was like, it didn't just disappear. As soon as I walked outside, I wasn't even thinking. As soon as I walked outside, I was just like, whoa. Now, what was that? That was not an airplane. I know what a fucking airplane looks like, you know? That wasn't no blue beam. That was it. Now I knew that. You just know your spirit when you see a chair. You want to scoot down right there in the shade? You good? That part.
Probably 4, 31. He says, for Yahweh thy God is a merciful God, he will not forsake you when you destroy thee, nor forget the covenant of thy fathers which you swore unto them. Well, as now, yeah.
Well, that's something people don't know either. Today, thousands of years ago, they took part in that covenant. Moses took the blood, he sprinkled it on the people. You know where that's at? They all part of that covenant. They all broke the Lord's covenant, whether they know it or not. You know? There's something in the Bible called reincarnation. We all come back reincarnated. And all these Israelites done broke the covenant. They're like, I ain't take no covenant. Yes, you did.
Well, as now, the days are past, since the day that Yahweh created man upon the earth, and asked from the one side of heaven to another, whether there have been any such things as great as this great thing is, or have been heard like it. Did ever people hear the voice of God speaking out of the midst of the fire, as thou hast heard and lived? Or have God assuaged to go and take him, a nation from the midst of another nation, by temptations, by signs, and by wonders? What are you talking about? Those signs, wonders, signs, wonders.
Talk about Egypt too, when he took Israel out of the land of Egypt. He showed them signs and them wonders. Oh, he saved them with a chariot then. There's the cloud, the cloud by day, pillar of fire by night, that was the chariots. And that's how he gonna save us during they're gonna be another exodus.
What's your spoiled ass chick?
What you got, bro?
You want that close up experience again. If not, the hell with
it. He's selling that shit? What's the other shit? These are wireless?
Yep. Both wireless.
You want 5 of those?
Yep.
Are they in there?
Yeah, bro.
$5 for both of them?
I think you want 5 of them. Hold up. Actually, I need some help on the work.
By signs, by wonders.
Which one you getting?
I just wanted those little ones, the earbuds. Are they Bluetooth?
Yeah, Bluetooth. By war and by a mighty hand and by a stretched out arm and by great terrors, according to all that Yahweh your God did for you in Egypt before your eyes. That's great. The Lord said, have anybody else heard the voice of God and live? All these signs and wonders shown to Israel. You
seen this shit, and they can still, you know, claim against the Most High as if they'd never seen that shit. So even if the Lord came down right now and abducted so-called abducted people, put them into a chair and brought them right back, they still wouldn't believe. They still would go against the Most High.
Yeah, because they would think, maybe I imagine that. And they try to come up with some bullshit in their mind why they ain't got to listen to the Lord.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You know, somebody $5.
Huh?
You know, somebody some money.
Why, you need money?
No.
Oh, okay.
Damn, dude, you pay.
Out there hustling, boy. Gotta make that money somehow. Oh, you Rick has to get out of the room.
Says,
where's that at?
Says, for ask now if the days have passed before thee. Yeah, like again, going back to the you see that when the tribulation comes upon you, when you're about to get tested of faith, remember the time when you see the chariot, and that you put right there, Most High through. Alright, for us now, the days that are past, but before thee, so the days that God created man upon the earth, ask them from one side of heaven to the other, whether there have been any such thing as this great thing is, have been heard like it. Ever people hear the voice of God speaking out of the midst of the fire, and thou hast heard of this?
Yeah, that was going into the Lord actually appeared before the children of Israel. I'll go ahead. Because the Lord actually, when we got the Ten Commandments, that was spoken by the voice of the Lord himself. And the Israelites were terrified. You know? That's what he's like, we want to talk to Moses. We ain't trying to, you know? It's so terrifying. Everybody out here, they think, oh, I would love to see the Most High. Man, you seen the Most High, he'd probably kill you talking to you. You don't even want to talk to an angel, let alone the Most High.
We ain't going to see the Most High until you get your kingdom.
Yep.
And that's a gift for us.
But the Most High is not even dealing with us like that.
You know what I'm saying? Right.
That's what it said. Whoever saw the face of God and lived, or something like that.
Yeah.
It says, or who hath God swayed to go and take him a nation from the midst of another nation by temptations, by signs, by wonders, and by war, and by a mighty hand, and by a stretched out arm, and by great terrors, according to all that Yahweh your God did for you in Egypt before your eyes, unto thee it was showed, that thou mightest know that Yahweh, that Yahweh he is God, there is none else beside him. Out of heaven he made thee to hear his voice, that he might instruct thee. And upon earth he showed thee his great fire, and thou heardest his word out of the midst of the fire.
Hey, that's a good one. Out of the midst of the fire. You're talking about, you know, them chariots. Because you read the Exodus, what, the 19th chapter and the 20th chapter. Tell you how the Most High descended down upon Mount Sinai in a great, in fire and flames. It sounds like a ship landing on top of the Mount Sinai.
Said to drive out nations from before thee, greater and mightier than thou art, to bring thee in, to give thee their land for an inheritance as it is this day. Know therefore this day, and consider it in thine heart. And Yahweh, he is God in heaven above, and upon the earth beneath, there is none else.
Yeah, he's the Most High, bro. There's only one creator, one Most High, Heavenly Father.
For we are saved by hope. The hope that is seen is not hope.
Huh.
Two-thirds hope is
hope. Hey, that's part of that hope. We hoping that the Lord gonna bring them chariots back.
Yep, that's
how we're gonna get saved, is we're gonna get beamed up by them chariots. That's why they get that old song, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot. Coming for to take me home. That's that hope. That was hoping and praying that the Lord would save them right then and there. But that wasn't the time yet. Because they knew back in them days that the chariots, that the so-called UFOs, they seen UFOs, been seeing them for thousands of years, bro.
And then they correct themselves. Even if they seen it, they don't believe it.
That's true, because they,
you know,
they did see it.
White women were delivered out of Egypt.
They seen the Lord split the sea.
Shit, I remember how Sean said, when he was talking to that parable, the Lazarus dude, the other rich dude, he said, let me come back and tell my family that, stop doing what y'all doing, whatever, and y'all shot, or somebody said, Abraham said, like, even if he did come back, they still wouldn't.
Yeah, they still ain't gonna believe.
For we are saved by hope that is seen is not hope. for what a man seeth, like doth he yet hope for. But if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for.
Yeah, so people just say you crazy.
You have a
sword? You say the Torah?
The sword.
What's that?
I asked y'all speaking the sword.
The
sword.
The sword.
I just...
Are we reading out the Bible?
Yeah, well, I understand. I understand the Torah scripture. The sword. Now, I just seen this gentleman here. I was wondering if you guys were speaking the sword. Torah practices. Business
meetings
don't have to speak. That's all.
What's
the story?
A gentleman?
Yeah, like the story, like business. You know, I guess some people will call it like the New Testament. Yeah. Like that. But, no issue. I'm just saying. Just me and you. I know the great. So, see how the chart is,
yeah? Well, you are. You're nationality. You can't change your nationality. You can call yourself whatever you want, but you can't change your nationality.
Book of the Hebrew. They call Abraham a Hebrew.
Yeah, Hebrew.
All right, it don't really say Hebrew either, but obviously, because you got different sects of Hebrews. You got Edomites are also Hebrew. You know what I mean? You got Moabites are Hebrew. So that's why you got to make a distinction.
Not Moab.
Huh?
Not Moab.
Yeah, anybody that comes out of Abraham. Actually, anybody that descends from Eber. Anybody that comes from
Come on.
Who?
No.
No.
Came
out
of Lot and $2.
Yeah. Even the Ammonites were also.
No, so Eber. I was listening. No issue. I was just saying this.
So what do you believe?
I believe in Moses.
I believe in, you know, I understand. What you believe his name is? Oh, you know, Most High?
Most High.
Is it? I can't hear you. Yeah, who
is it? Even outside of that translation, he was Ethiopian sister, the brother sister. Like, that's what I come
with. Ethiopians ain't brothers.
It's like you have us here in America, you have us in Ethiopia.
And even we were there before they got us, we were separated then.
When the Son of Man shall come in his glory and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory, and before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them one from another, as a shepherd divided his sheep from the goats. But he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on the left.
Goat on. We're the sheep.
Yeah.
We're sheep.
Oh, you're talking about like the scapegoat.
Who's referring to? The scripture referring to.
Yeah.
Did you listen to the scripture?
No, actually, I got it.
You can't get up. You know, it's
okay. I got it.
Check this out. Read this. Listen to this. Because remember, we are the curses. You see, the Hebrew Israelites were the curses, man. Right? And many curses. Many curses.
Oh Lord, righteousness belongs unto thee, and unto us confusion of faces. As to this day, to the men of Judah, and to the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and to all Israel that are near and that are far off.
Do you know that are near and that are far off? Scatter. So growing up amongst the other nations, you will get your seed will get you something to look like the other nations. So that's just a curse, man. This right here, that's not a motherfucker that's going to work, nor his seed. He does not do the work.
I got a precept for you.
Is he Adam?
Huh? No.
An Israelite.
No, he's an Israelite. Listen, you didn't listen to the scripture again.
But
listen to the scripture. Listen, man. You gotta listen to the scripture.
I get what the scripture said.
What did it say?
We're mixed amongst population.
But read it again. You're missing the point.
No, I just
go on and read it.
Righteousness belongs unto thee, but unto us.
Confusion of faces. So you without even knowing the brother, you already calling them.
Right.
Should not she be ashamed?
Ooh.
But this right here said, if you look at two words, I believe it's two words in the same word. I believe it's commandments or something like that. To look like that is shame. So us having confusion of faces, us looking like other nations, you know what I'm saying?
So you saying like these people here too, are you caught?
You gotta try the spirit. Scripture say you gotta try the spirit. Like Bruce Lee's an Israelite. Oh, you know who Bruce Lee is, right?
Carnal.
Yeah, that's a perfect example. Bruce Lee.
He said Bruce Lee.
That's an Israelite.
How do you know that?
Because the spirit bears witness.
But I
can go down. The spirit itself bears witness.
But Israel, yeah. Israel are those that were born over the park, yeah.
Jacob, right.
Yeah, Jacob.
Right.
So,
right. Jacob.
That's a carnal DNA.
What separates us from Israelites and the people? What separates us? What makes us separate?
What would make it? There's ways to go about identifying
What about Eminem?
I mean, when you say outshine, what do you think
better? They better at Eastern.
Anyone has like a talent or a gift with that person.
Show me one or two.
Show me even what I should say. A rap.
Give me one example of a heathen, outside of church. Give me one example.
Eminem's
an Edomite?
I don't know what he's I know he's not caught. Yeah.
Right, see, that's everything you know now, you gotta just dump that shit out and learn all over again. So you can learn the truth.
Even Rakim said Eminem's the greatest.
Continue to hold on what you know, which is not wisdom, which is neither the truth.
Okay.
You can't learn, you're not gonna learn nothing.
Because
the Most High require you to humble yourself, and everything you learn, you gotta cast it off and be born again.
Okay.
What you think being born again mean, man? Die and gonna be come back out, you know?
Well, I'm not the kind of junk, but what I'm saying is you talking your part, right? I pitched to you that he's not, I'm speaking on he's not of the seed of your pop.
That's
what
makes you. Who's not? Who's not? Okay.
And I was happy to have it. Yeah, before I get mad, but like, I was happy.
So, Eminem, if you look at his lifestyle growing up, that motherfucker was under curses like a motherfucker. He was on drugs, mama ain't shit. Dad probably ain't around.
Yeah, his dad was beat to shit.
Who are those curses in Deuteronomy 4?
We're talking about like people, right? We're talking about calling them demons.
Talking about people, yeah.
Is Maryland going to get him out
of there? He had leprosy.
I get that Leviticus.
Well, I'm not talking about, again, I don't want you guys to think I'm talking to you with skin color or anything like that. I'm speaking the Tarnio lineage.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about.
Are you? Are you of?
Well, I know my father. You know.
You got a genealogy going all the way back to Jacob.
Like, I mean,
yeah, what's your original?
Like, for instance, like, you know, I don't want to really get like all crazy in my life. I'm gonna just show. Like, for me, this is no disrespect to me. This is why, you know, coach is perfect. As far as tools. Then I can fact that random me another mall, Wayne, I'm not under the same statue per se. Real statue you have to be like that.
I'll read that stuff.
For our ancestral. But my family's been slaves the whole time.
Correct.
But we don't put them together. I have my whole life. That's how poor we are.
Through Ethiopians.
I was always spoken to me.
You know, Ethiopians have been here for like a good, not even 20 years.